Dolly Transformations video, I am going to be fixing up this Bitty Baby. I have a tendency to find Bitty Baby dolls in the wild. I have seen tons and tons that I haven't purchased. I'm guessing it's because they're usually bought for much younger kids and they get trashed and then the parents don't really think they're worth anything. So I have actually gotten several of my babies for a dollar each. So this lady, I found her over the weekend in early of June of 2024. She was in a container with a bunch of random toys and it was fill a bag for $5. So of course I had to grab her. I named her Asia. She is pretty gross. I will show you a close up of her. But she has like stuff in her lips and marks all over her front and back and she's just very, very grubby. So I'm going to be making her over today, and I know it's not as exciting maybe as like a regular American girl because she doesn't have a wig, but without further ado, let's get into it. So I use the same method to clean American girls that I use to clean any other type of doll. I even use the same toothbrush because I find that it works better than just using a rag. And actually, the reason I use baking soda in the first place is because when I was a kid, we bought the skincare kit for American Girl dolls from the catalog, and we noticed that the ingredient was just baking soda in the special powder. So that's where I got the idea, and it's super effective, super cheap. I always have it around. I use baking soda for all sorts of things. It's also very gentle. It's like abrasive enough to get marks off, but it doesn't like sand anything down. And using the toothbrush enables you to get into little nooks and crannies. And I use dish soap too, just to kind of help get some surface dirt off. But if you just use dish soap, you're not going to get like a really, really deep clean. So yeah, I'm getting her body wet. It doesn't matter. You'll see why I'm going to be taking her apart. She had a lot of little marks that I needed to pay attention to. I do occasionally bust out a magic eraser for really stubborn marks. You have to be careful with magic erasers. They're actually a very, very fine sander. That's why it can take off face paint and stuff. I will cut like my magic erasers into quarters. Makes them last longer and it's easier to work into small spaces. I don't buy the like name brand, I just buy the Walmart brand. Works about the same. Now, some people clean exclusively with a magic eraser. Now, I just want to point out that like these are a type of sponge. Not all of them have cleaners in them. So it might be like sanding off the grub, but it's not actually necessarily cleaning the doll. So if they're really gross and you want them to actually be cleaned and smell nice, then definitely make sure you're either A, buying a magic eraser with cleaner in it, or you're using like some kind of soap too. I like dish soap because it's like gentle but also has a lot of like cleaning properties. And you can see here I did use it even a little bit on the hair because she doesn't have much paint there, but she had some really stubborn marks. And you can use your fingernail too to help gently get off some of them, but she had quite a few stubborn ones. No paint came off because I was being very gentle here. And yes, I did get some water in her eyes. Don't worry, you will see why. It was unavoidable. Her face was really grubby, and that's just gonna happen. It's not like they're gonna die or anything, and silver eye will not happen. That's a factory defect. It has nothing to do with water. Now it's time for the deep clean of her torso. So I'm using a small flathead screwdriver to help get the knot out of her neck. If they have a zip tie, you'll have to use like a seam ripper to cut a few strings that are keeping the zip tie enclosed, and then you'll have to like cut the zip tie out with a wire cutter. But the dolls with strings are pretty easy to get in and out of. Her head did look funny once it was off because it reminded me of the baby from Toy Story. Some stuffing actually went inside her head when I pulled it off, so I had to pull it out. That's what I was doing there. And then I'm going to load all of her stuffing up into a pillowcase. The easiest way to wash, like, the stuffing is to run it through the wash
washing machine and then the dryer, because if you hand wash it and then have it air dry, the stuffing takes a really long time to dry. I've tried it both ways. But the body itself can't be run through the wash, definitely not on Bitty Babies or American Girls, like the 18-inch dolls, because they have plastic components that could get banged up or obviously melt in the dryer. So I'm going to hand wash this like I do with doll laundry in a little tub with some water and some detergent and also a little bit of OxyClean. You'll see that in a second. This is a really good way to deep clean the doll, but it's not hard. Bitty Babies are actually a really good starter doll if you want to put your toes in the water with cleaning American Girls, but you're intimidated. Here I am getting some laundry detergent and some OxyClean to wash her cloth torso. You have to be mindful that Bitty Baby's arms and legs aren't removable. They're glued into their cloth bodies. So when you soak their bodies, water is going to go inside the limbs. So it's important, like when you go to hang them to dry, to shake out the limbs really well. I let her soak for maybe an hour or so, and then I hung her out to dry. And I did move this clip of me rinsing her body after she soaked for a while, right after I showed me preparing it, but it soaked for longer. I did other things with her stuffing and all that in the meantime, but it's important to make sure, like I said, all the water is shaken out. You can see I'm shaking it. I should have done it more aggressively because I had to do it again later. And here I'm in my laundry room to wash the stuffing. I put some detergent right in the pillowcase with the stuffing, and then I just run it through a cycle with some clothes you can see in there, and I remembered to bring my ring light down here, so there's actually decent lighting in my very dark laundry room, which is lit only by a single light bulb. Anyways, I'm adding more detergent in for the rest of the clothes. I just like to put some directly in the pillowcase. I always do this after I wash American Girls. I use a blow dryer on the cold setting, not warm, not hot, cold. Dusting. I've heard different things. Some people will say, oh, it's aluminum at the back of their eyes so it won't rust. But then I've had people show me pictures of like a doll they got used that had rusty eyes, so it's better to be safe than sorry. And when you have to clean a doll this dirty, like, it's kind of inevitable some water will get behind there, but this takes care of it. It also helps cloudy eyes on other dolls with these like blinky type eyes. And after her stuffing went through the dryer cycle, because yes, you can put it in the dryer, I went to restuff her. This was actually the next day because it turns out I didn't shake her limbs out well enough, so then her body got all wet, so it had to dry overnight. The bodies don't take long to dry, though. And I'm packing in all of her stuffing. I'm sorry for the awkward angle. I don't have like a flip-around viewfinder on my camera, so I kind of have to guess when I'm setting up. Now, the interesting thing about Bitty Babies, they're not stuffed as well as 18-inch dolls, so you don't really need to pack it in as densely as you do if you're restuffing like a Truly Me or historical character. I packed it down really well, and then I realized I had run out of stuffing, and so I just had to fluff it up a bit. And then once I finished with that, I reattached her head. She has neck string, so that was easier. And it was easier putting her head back on because she doesn't have hair. I didn't have to worry about the hair. So it's like the same process with an 18-inch doll. If you do break the neck strings, you can always put a zip tie in, or if they're starting to get weak, you can put a zip tie in with the string.
She has a lot of like scuffs and different colored marks on her head, and she's also really dirty looking. Like, you can tell her skin tone is very grubby. There's something pink all in her lips. I'm not sure if it's lipstick or marker. Hopefully something that comes out easy. Then the back of her head is just as bad. There's all kinds of scuffs and transfer stains. Her body is pilled. I don't know how well that's showing up, but it's pilled and dirty looking. Her limbs don't seem that bad, considering. this is Asia after. So you can see she's much cleaner. She doesn't have any marks on the back of her head, and I didn't even need to touch up her paint. All that yucky stuff is off of her lips. Her eyebrows are in really nice condition. She's got these beautiful eyes, and she's also way less scrubby looking. And I actually do have what could be her meat sleeper. It's probably the most likely option because of like what date I kind of pegged this doll being at, but I bought this years ago when it went on sale through American Girl's website, and because I needed the Bitty Bear that was sold with it, and it had a diaper and everything, so now she has her outfit. Although I do need to get her a diaper, I don't have any spares right now, but she looks super cute in the pastel carousel dress. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see pictures of Asia or any of my other dolls, feel free to check out my Flickr. You don't need one to view my photos. And until next time, love your dolls, love yourself, and love your life.